What up guys, welcome back to the channel, Jamal here, and in today's video I'm going to be doing something a little different. I know I usually talk about coding, but I'm going to be talking to you a little bit about crypto and this new altcoin that's becoming very popular, and it's called SAFEMOON. And I'm just going to show you how you can actually purchase it using your MetaMask wallet. Alright guys, so SAFEMOON is a new DeFi token that's becoming extremely popular recently. I'm just going to show you on how you can get some of it while it's very very cheap. So if you go to the how to buy section, the first thing you want to do is download the trust wallet. I already downloaded that. I'm not going to follow everything in here. I'm going to just change it up a little bit, but pretty much you're going to achieve the same thing. You are going to need some BNB token, and I'm going to be using the Binance US. So you go into my Binance US account. I do have some BNB and a little bit of Bitcoin right now in there, and what I need to do is I'm going to take some of this BNB token and I'm going to actually withdraw that and deposit it into my BNB trust wallet. But before we do that, let's go and set up our MetaMask wallet. So if you click MetaMask, we do need to configure this to accept the Binance Smart Chain. So what you're going to do is you're going to go, when you first start, is normally on the Ethereum mainnet. You do have to get the smart chain, and I'm going to show you how you can add that. It's very very easy. To add that, what you'll need to do is just open up this little icon, click settings, and you're going to scroll down to networks, and you want to add a network. So for these type of settings, you can, so right here, it just tells you on how you can connect your MetaMask to the smart chain. This is the stuff that you're going to be inputted in. So if I go back into MetaMask and I go back to settings, I scroll down and I see networks, add networks. So the details over here, you're going to be using the mainnet one. You're going to just be transferring it in here, and then you're going to click save. I already did it. So that's why you see smart chain to the top, and that's what you're going to need. And while you're here, we could definitely add the SAFEMOON token. So I already have this added, but in order to add the SAFEMOON token, it's pretty easy as well too. All you have to do is just add token, and we're going to enter the custom token right here. So to find the custom token, you just go back to SAFEMOON and you're going to copy this address at number 4. And once you copy that, you go back into your MetaMask wallet, add token, custom, and then you're going to paste. For me, I'm going to get an error, token has already been added, but for you, everything should be auto-filled, and you click next, and you should be good. So now that we've set up our MetaMask to be on the smart chain, and we have our SAFEMOON token ready to go, we're going to go back into my Binance US account, and again I will need to transfer some of this BNB into my trust wallet. We go into withdraw. We don't get the option of the BEP20. The BEP20 is the smart chain network, and with that we would have been able to just copy our MetaMask address and paste it in here and then send our BNB to that area. But since we don't have the BEP20, I'll have to send some of this BNB to my trust wallet, and once I have that in my trust wallet, I can convert it into the BSC, the Binance Smart Chain. So what I'm going to do is just pretty much need to go to my phone and pull up the trust wallet. Alright, so right now I'm going to click the trust wallet. So once I'm in here, this is the BNB. This is what I need to receive, so I'm just going to click receive. I'm going to copy this address so I can paste it and hop it over to my computer. I can just click copy, and that's going to copy the address for me. Alright, so I'm just going to hop back over to my screen. So I already have it here saved. I'm just going to copy this. I'm going to paste it here. That looks good. I'm just going to put for SAFEMOON in the memo, and the amount that I want to send. So the minimum that we can withdraw is 0.002. Let's do 0.009 for the heck of it. So I'm gonna submit this. It's gonna send me a text. I have to go to my email. All right, so now that request has been sent successfully. So now I should get some of that in my Trust wallet. All right, so we just got our deposit. Oh, there it is, $2.74. Oh wow, only. So that just came in. All right, so what you wanna do is you're gonna click the BNB and more, swap to Smart Chain, and that's what we're gonna do. And my balance is 0.008, so 0.008, 100% swap. So now I'm converting the BNB to the BNB Smart Chain version. There's a little bit of a network fee of $1.39, so pretty much ain't gonna have nothing. Now we wait. All right, so there it is. We just received it, so now we have $1.34 worth of BNB. Not too bad. So now that we have our BNB, what we can do now is we can transfer this BNB into our MetaMask wallet. But the balance is pretty low, so I may have to add some more in there, and then I'm going to send it. So, all right. Just had to add a little bit more money in the account. So now we at $23.50. Much better than $1.34, I think. Yeah, that was terrible. Anyway, so now that we have some more funds in our Binance Smart Chain, what we need to do is hop over to MetaMask. Let's hop back over to MetaMask. And what we need to do right now is we need to copy this address. You can copy it, email it to yourself or whatever, but you do need to go back to the Trust Wallet app. So I already have this address copied. I already emailed it to myself on my phone, so I'm just gonna hop back over to my phone and pretty much copy it. So notes, I have my MetaMask BNB Smart Wallet address, so I just need to copy this. I click copy. Let's head back to the Trust Wallet, and I'm going to click on the Smart Chain, and I'm going to do send. I put the recipient address. I'm going to paste that, and the amount. I was putting in the dollar amount. You got to make sure put the BNB amount, so which is about $23. So I just hit max, click next, click send. Just give it a little bit of time for this to get sent into our MetaMask account, and once it's in there, alright, sent, nice. Once it's in the MetaMask wallet, that's when we can actually go into one of these, either PancakeSwap or BakerySwap. I'm gonna be using BakerySwap. I love this little website, pretty good when it comes to details. So BakerySwap, this is what I'm gonna be using. Let's see if we got our token as yet. There we go, we did get it. So 0.07. This was about 0.02 early, I think. So we did get our BNB. It's in here nicely. So that leads me to heading over to the BakerySwap. I'm gonna click BakerySwap here, do the conversion for SAFEMOON and BNB. All right, so now that I'm on BakerySwap, what you need to do is connect your MetaMask wallet. So you normally click this and connect. I'm already connected at the time. So, oh, and good. Sometimes it's gonna take a while for you to see this. Be patient, but wait until you see this, and then you're gonna click SAFEMOON. All right, so I have my balance of 0.07, and let's say if I wanna buy 0.02 worth, let's see what happens. Is the impact too high? So about one. All right, one works. Let's do swap anyways. Okay, continue. So I'm glad that it did this. So sometimes you may see insufficient output amount, and it took me a while to figure this out. So what you need to do is just clear this and actually enter the amount in the tool section. So let's say I want to buy 500,000 shares of SAFEMOON. I will enter 500,000. I'm gonna click swap. I'm gonna click confirm. It connected to the MetaMask. We have our gas fees and stuff. I'm not gonna bother with it too much. You're just gonna click confirm, and your transaction has been submitted. Just give it a while. It's gonna be pending. It usually runs pretty fast. And once that's done being in the pending state, you can do this process over and over until you get the desired amount of SAFEMOON. It took me a while. There is like some cap limits I saw of like 1 million or 2 million. It gets a little weird after that. Oh, it tells you you can't go above it. Let's see, like if I do 3 million, price impact too high. So you have to find that safe spot. Let's do 2 million. So 2 million is, it's telling you the price impact is a little high, but it will do it. So if I try to do 2 million, swap anyway, it asks you to confirm, so that normally happens. Click confirm, it connects to the MetaMask, and I can proceed. And yeah, you just do this over and over, and this is how you build up your SAFEMOON. Right now I have about 98 million worth of it. Oh, 100 million worth of... SAFEMOON, so that's pretty good. Hopefully things rises and things get better, but that's how you pretty much get SAFEMOON. So it was a little bit of a lengthy process, but you know, that's just the way it is. The process you just have to go through right now. I hope that just was helpful. If you did find this helpful, please feel free to smash that like button, subscribe to the channel. I usually talk about coding and software engineering, and cryptos is something that I do as well. So I'm probably going to be touching a little bit on that. Some of new altcoins, what altcoins I have this year, you know, upcoming ones and so forth. So definitely look forward to the content. I'll see you guys in another video. Peace out.